band to a new band, the Hoodoo Gurus.
Back in the early 80s, when synth was king, Hoodoo Gurus were carving out a scene of their own. What's my scene? The Gurus spent the 80s and 90s topping the charts, touring the world and solidifying their place in Aussie rock history. They even gave the NRL an official anthem. The band has been working hard to bring us more of that Guru's magic with a new single that might be their biggest trump card yet.
Joining us now is Hoodoo Gurus lead singer Dave Faulkner. Great to see you, Dave.
Great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Just going to go out on a limb here and say I reckon this latest single is about Donald Trump. is it safe to assume...
You must have read the tea leaves or something. Yeah. How'd you figure that out?
I have a talent for these things. Can I assume it's not a love song?
It's the exact opposite of a love song, in fact. It's I hate you song. And, in fact, that was the reason we did the video, to make sure people knew it was about a specific person rather than just someone I know.
Well, you guys have always been rebels, but you haven't really been renowned as a political band. Why now?
Just anger and frustration at what we've seen going on over there. I mean, I love science, and seeing the way that the current administration is so anti-science and the way they've handled COVID-19 has been a disgrace. And, you know, I've got friends over there and I just find it horrific what they're going through.
You guys are wearing Trump masks in the video clip, but there is, of course, that moment where Trump leans in and has a kiss with Putin. And can I just ask, was there a particular reason why you...
Spoiler alert!
Was there a particular reason why you felt compelled to give us nightmares in that regard?
Well, it was the Thelma and Louise ending, so we just wanted to kind of do the whole thing. And also, let's be honest, you know he's really up him. You know, this is the way it is. So, you know, we wanted to sort of make it material what we know is happening in reality, you know?
This is the most rock and roll interview we have done with the least rock and roll outfit, by the way, Dave.
Thank you. I'm trying to fool you all with my, being dapper.
No, I love the video. I always thought Thelma and Louise should have been in the golf buggy, Dave. I'm glad you've corrected that. Hey, Dave, there's a long list of musicians and artists who have banned Trump from using their songs during his rallies.
Bring it on, baby.
Would you happily donate this one?
He can have it as many times, all the time he wants. It's for free. We'll even play a rally for him. Oh, maybe not. He might get killed.
Dave, I grew up in a magical time for Australian music. I was in grade 5 and 6 when Blow Your Cool came out. I think Diesel and Dust was around the same time. Kick, Crowded House's debut album, Man of Colours. James Rain was doing his thing, Paul Kelly. Like, it was just a magical time. Can you just give us a quick reflection on that time?
Well, you know, it was really weird because I guess that was a product of the fact that we had so many live venues and people were going out. It was before the internet, so there was no dating apps. So people would go out on a Monday or Tuesday night to meet people and, you know, maybe get lucky. And there were bands there. And, you know, basically instead of going to a chat room or something where, you know, your particular, you know, group of people would hang out online, you'd go to a pub where the sort of music that you relate to and the people you wanted to meet that liked that music would go. So it was, you know, a similar kind of idea where people would use you to network.
Hey, I've always wanted to know this. So the song What's My Scene has one of my favourite opening lines ever because the first line is, and another thing. When did you figure out that the best way to start a song was right in the middle of a conversation we hadn't heard?
It's great.
Well, it's what it was literally when I was writing the song. I wrote the melody first and those notes sounded like those syllables to me. I didn't know why I was saying that, but it just seemed to be, they fit really well. And then I kind of discovered the lyric as I was going along, and I'm the sort of person that's always questioning who I am and where I fit in, so that song was a natural subject for me to explore. But And Another Thing was kind of the way those notes sounded. Someone else might have heard something else, but for me, that was what I heard.
I'm going to try to do this in interviews from now on. I might just start them in the middle. See if it makes any sense to anyone. The latest single from the Hoodoo Gurus, Hung Out to Dry, will be available Friday, July 24. Dave, it's always a pleasure. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, guys. Cheers. Pleasure.